Hey, it's Matt Bomer. I'm here at one of my favorite events all year, Gold Meets Golden, where we get to meet our idols, these incredible Olympic athletes who come to intermingle with actors and inspire us. So, welcome.
Nicole Kidman, who's become one of our big partners for the event. She's a huge supporter of the Olympics.
And her hosting this event, it's amazing that she's doing that for such a great cause. Bringing Hollywood together with sports, it's a great feeling, and I'm so glad to be here.
Afterwards, how long do you take off?
I would say I'm taking off about a year before I begin training again, but I've been working out pretty much every day, especially when I'm with him. He's training for a football season right now, so he's training really hard right now, so I have him, I watch him, and sometimes I just want to lay in bed and not work out, but he always motivates me.
Well, that's helpful. Also, you had some time afterwards to celebrate and to experience the Olympics, so that must have been a lot of fun to just enjoy Rio and the experience.
Yes. We did have a media day, and then we did get a day to ourselves, so we went to the beach, and that was a lot of fun. The water was really cold, so we didn't get in it too much, but it was still a lot of fun to be with the girls and just be relaxed.
Any sport that you'd like to be, if you had to pick one that you would compete in the Olympics?
Olympics? Golf.
Yeah, I'm an incredible golfer.
Oh, so...
In my own mind.
What's your handicap?
My handicap? Half Chinese, I guess.
You could compete in, what would it be?
Gymnastics, women's gymnastics.
It is the best. I mean, Nadia Comaneci right here.
Well, I'm here today. I'm actually singing one of the songs from La La Land.
Amazing.
Yes. So, I mean, I saw the film. It's such a love letter to Los Angeles.
Just recently announced you're retiring. What's next?
I'm pretty excited.
Yeah. So far, it's exciting because we get to come to stuff like this, which we didn't get to as athletes. So, yeah, I mean, we just didn't have time. So. So far, it's awesome.
Yeah. Now, if you want a cupcake or whatever, you know.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, as an athlete, that pressure, and for them, it really does always come down to that one moment.
And yeah, the thing is, you talk about pressure. Some athletes won't admit to it, but I mean, when you're competing against the best of the best, how can you not have a little pressure? And I think that's what brings the best out of any athlete.
So, if you could pick an Olympic sport to compete in, what would it be?
Me? I'll probably do diving so I can show off my abs. No, I'm just kidding. I would not want to do diving. I did that a few years back. I did Stars in Danger. That was probably the most exhausting sport that I've ever done.
You know, if I had the courage and the ability, I think it'd be amazing and the poise to do like the 3-meter platform diving.
Yeah, to stand up. Greg Louganis is here.
Love Greg. He's an amazing guy and I'm obviously a huge fan. But I just think what they do, the amount of athleticism and poise you have to do a handstand that high up and then a bunch of flips and twists with a bunch of people watching you, man, you could probably do anything if you can do that.
When you watch the sport today, has it changed a lot or is it basically just the same, maybe they do a one extra flip here and there?
You know, it's changed a bit because the emphasis is on degree of difficulty, so they're doing the more difficult dives. It's amazing what they're doing now. I'm glad I'm retired, so it's fun to see.